I posed the question a couple months ago, wondering how many goals are generated from plays starting below the goal line, whether it be side to side, behind the net, switching sides, whether it be just passes out from the goal line to the slot. Here I noticed a pattern a couple nights ago. There was a handful of goals across the NHL starting with plays that are generated from plays starting below the goal line. Here you got Crosby switching directions behind the net, finding his teammate out in front, and the goalie in this case is going post to post along the goal line and cannot get out to cut the angle down, thus giving the shooter a lot of room, a lot of choices really of where he wants to put that puck. We'll get to the next one here. We've got Goligoski from Dallas. He finds an opening in the slot, gets the pass from his teammate, and in this case, the goalie from Carolina, Khudobin, he doesn't stay on the goal line. He rushes out to cut down the angle. As he's rushing out, though, he doesn't allow himself to get set and really doesn't get to react. All he's trying to do is make himself big to stop this puck. No form coming out. By the time he gets his arm set, that puck has already passed him. Hartnell with Columbus Blue Jackets. I like this one because the puck changes sides behind the net here, getting the goalie on the goal line, switching sides. By the time he switches sides, the puck is already out in front on Hartnell's stick and then in the back of the net just as quick. We have another Pittsburgh one here. Crosby below the goal line, stopping short, finding Hornquist in the slot. And again, the Edmonton goalie cannot get out in time. Here we've got Iginla scoring with Colorado. Again, theme is the same deal. Puck goes below the goal line, out front. There's a little scramble in this one here, too. And I like it because it highlights how hard it is for these goalies to readjust and get out off the goal line here. Little turnover right there by New Jersey, but this puck is being bounced around. Again, the goalie has not had a chance to get out and cut the angle down. He's been in ready position ever since the first time that puck squirted out. And now he's in the crouch position, given many opportunities, many choices for Iginla in his shot. You can just see here the struggle that he has on where to go. He's still deep in his net, not at the top of the paint there. Not cutting much down. Now he's getting further back as the play progresses. Easy goal for Iginla. And then we've got Mathot here on Ottawa against Carey Price. Puck comes out. Price hardly gets that right foot off the goal line at all. The puck is in the back of the net. So I believe that the teams that defend best are the teams that know how to defend against plays like this. Save their goalies, play some strong defense in their own end, they have to figure out how they're going to combat side switches behind the net, pucks getting out from below the goal line to the slot. You'll see also if you go back and watch this how many players on the defending team have their eyes that are puck focused on that puck below the goal line, allowing guys to elude them and get open behind them in the slot.